Namaste.
Namaste.
Namaste. How's life? Hope this finds you in great spirits. I hope this finds you full of life and full of creativity and full of creative energy, really. I think that's all that when we're locked down, that's all we've got, creative energy. That's all we've got. You know, we've got a busy mind that we're here right now to slow down. And one of my musician friends is even digging the garden now, you know. So, you know, that's a breakthrough. You never know where the blessings come.
Oh, Hannah is watching.
Is Hannah? Our really dear friend, Hannah, it's her birthday today. She takes care of all our stuff. And she's a great girl. Hannah, you're a great girl. We're saying it publicly. And we'll sing a mantra for you if you're still awake at the end of the meditation.
Oh, Hannah, you guys have to know about Hannah because she is really behind the scenes the person who makes it all happen and is so graceful and amazing in it, with it, and has been with us for maybe 8 years now or something, 7-8 years, and she's just such a blessing in our lives and such a
just like
gift.
You.
So we're so happy that you're
happy birthday.
That you're here with us. Happy birthday, Hannah.
We're trying to get through all your requests
before lockdown is finished.
This one's a beautiful song from Brazil, Ilumina, if we can play it. Sorry, wrong key.
That's the wrong key, yeah?
Wrong key.
I thought it's very low now.
Time to maybe move a little your body while we play this little song in Brazil.
Ilumina, ilumina,
song that gives thanks to Mother Nature. And we're right, as you know, in the jungle, in a beautiful house close to the beach. We're very amazingly grateful to find ourselves here and be able to share some of the sunshine with you all. We wanted to be outside again. We'll take a risk tomorrow. Maybe we'll do it again outside. It's rain clouds are coming in the afternoon. You can see them building up now. So we didn't want to risk it. But it's nice to hear the birds. And I can tell you that the storms did not impact in any way the nest. The nest is still there, strong as ever. And the two little ones are backwards and forwards. One takes turns, the other one goes and comes like this. And above there's a woodpecker, and he's a little more shy and timid. But yesterday I went out into the garden and was barefoot, and I walked into an ant's nest. So my feet are kind of swollen today, but I couldn't get to sleep, so it was so itchy, but hey, that's the least of our problems. Beloveds, just let's have a moment to ourselves. Just close your eyes for a moment. This gathering is all about slowing down our minds, our busy minds. It's all it is. It's just about slowing down for a moment until we stop and the mind is still. The mind is still and we're off the treadmill. We're off the hook and we're just in this very precious moment together where there's no coming, no going, no history, no future, just this. And
there are different anchors into the moment and one is just simply to feel the ground beneath our sitting bones, our bodies, the way we touch the ground, the carpet or whatever we're sitting on. This is very much a feeling that just happens in this moment. You know, the way your body feels on the ground, it only happens this moment. You can only relate to that feeling right now because you don't know what it felt like to do that yesterday or tomorrow. So the body is such a great key doorway into the moment. Also the breath, how our breath comes and goes. It's a really great doorway into the moment.
Just check your body right now. How is it? Are you hunched or are you sitting straight? Are you hanging or are you sitting with intention? Because the mind is a very tricky guy, you know, and it's probably very good to pay attention to the way our body is because we need all our energy in these moments, especially when we're meditating. It's maximum energy, maximum intensity, maximum participation. So maximum awareness. So let's just check that. David, say, how do we feel with our body? Are we breathing deeply now? Beginning to slow down. We start to become aware of the sounds around us. Let's take a moment just to be with the sounds. These are not sounds to disturb the silence. All these sounds are there to be included in our silence, in our space. Nothing can disturb this silence. This space is ours. No government, no church, no religion, nothing penetrates this. This is our own internal reality. It's our sanctuary. So make friends with it. Make friends with yourself here. In a minute I will stop talking and we just have a moment to listen to the sounds. This is a very simple technique to bring you in the moment, because if you listening, not hearing, listening. If you're listening, you're not thinking. So this is what it's about. It's about tricking the mind so we can let it do its thing. It has to think about tomorrow, and but it doesn't have to do that right now. So we can have a moment without the mind interfering with our heartbeat and our breath. So just moments now to enjoy the silence, and then we will begin our meditation. A smile. This is not serious business. Do we want to introduce the
every day we are meditating on the sound of Om. And Om has no meaning, which is a beautiful thing, because it's just a sound, and its full potential is expressed just by the sound itself. You don't have to have an explanation for it or a translation for it in any language. It's just right there. It's Om. And it's such a good friend, because Om is available to us on every out-breath. As a friend, as a guru, as a reminder of the big picture, the great cosmic yes, Om. And it's beautiful when we do this all together, when we know that we are all doing it in the same rhythm. More or less, if your breathing is different to mine, don't worry about it. It's also not serious, but just that we have that intention of creating this wave of Om all together, taking a deep breath and then intoning the Om sound with an equal measure of O and M, so we can feel both sounds equally. They're equal, they have their own power, each one of those sounds. And then it comes back to stillness when we run out of breath and we take a deep next breath for the next round.
This is when the synchronicity happens, you know, when we're breathing in rhythm all over the world, thousands of us, and it's a beautiful synchronistic moment. It's just symbolic of taking each other's hands across the world with our breathing, with our silence, with our Om. And we will chant the Gayatri Mantra. And then we will come back to the cosmic yes, the Om sound. Thank you.
let's take a deep breath together and breathe out. And a deep breath.
Resonate in your body.
energies to you, Brent.
breath. Close your eyes if you have your eyes open. Close your eyes, come home. Enjoying the silence and the bliss of our sanctuary in here. Consciously being aware of the brothers and sisters who are we are connected with at this moment all over the world. Breath. You know, I just wanted to remind you again, you know, that if it's serious, it's not meditation. And by serious, I don't mean intense. There's a difference between, a big difference between seriousness and sincerity. I don't mean for us to be serious, but I mean for us to be sincere. Because you can be joyful and sincere, but you cannot be joyful and serious at the same time.
Mm-hmm.
You can be joyful and sincere. So the point is, our sincerity is the key, but seriousness is the door, and it's a door, that's all. You need the key to get in there, and that's sincerity. Okay, and I was wanting to play this song for you because it's written by my good friend Abhinandan. And Abhi, I know you have been a little under the weather lately, and you've written so many amazing songs for me and David Singh, and this is one of my favorites called One Breath. And we haven't played it for a long while, me and David, but we'll play it today for you, Abhi. One breath, breath of eternity. One song becomes a symphony of hearts meeting in harmony with you. Blessed one, one breath, breath of eternity. One song becomes a symphony of hearts meeting in harmony with you. Blessed one, one breath, breath of eternity. One song becomes a symphony of hearts beating in harmony together as one. One breath, breath of eternity. One song becomes a symphony of hearts beating in harmony with you. Blessed one, one breath, breath of eternity. One song becomes a symphony of hearts beating in harmony together as one. Breath of eternity. One song becomes a symphony of hearts meeting in harmony with you. Blessed one, one. Love you, Abby.
Hannah.
Hannah. So this
are
is.
Are you still there, Hannah?
Are you still awake? This is Hannah's favorite mantra, and
is it really the 28th in a row? I think it might be. I think we started four weeks ago. Time is really very, very
crazy.
Illusory.
Okay, Hannah, here you go. We start with the Om. Join me with the mantra Om. And it's been the ruin of many a poor girl. And God, I know I'm one. My mother was a tailor. She sold my new jeans. And my suitcase and a gun, and the only time he's ever satisfied is when he's on the run. Oh, mother, tell your children not to do what I have done. Spend your life in sin. The other on the train, I'm going back to New Orleans, to wear that ball and chain. We sing together. There is they call the rising sun, and it's been the ruin of many a poor girl, and God, I know I'm one.
Happy birthday,
darling. Happy birthday. I hope we didn't disturb your meditation with that song.
The reason how we found out that it was Hannah's favorite mantra was that we made a beautiful connection with Chiz, who runs Hart Street in Kingston, New York, and she has created this house for mentally ill homeless people to live together and to be safe and to be in a community. And Chiz had been writing to us for many years. You know, she loved our music and to connect, and when we went to play at Omega, which we do every year, we thought, wow, we can come to Chiz's place, to Hart Street, and play for them. Boy, if they would like that.
It's amazing to play for these guys. I asked them if for a request, that's the thing, isn't it? They would like to hear anything, and I was thinking of mantras, you know. You play mantras. And there was one guy sitting there, and do you want to say it?
Yeah.
Go.
I don't know. No, you say it.
Oh. Because Hannah was with us.
Hannah,
right?
Yeah.
Hannah was with us. And the guy called out. He said, hey, do you know House of the Rising Sun? And I said, sure do. And Hannah was like, oh, that's my favorite song, you know. So every birthday I have to find an excuse to sing House of the Rising Sun for Hannah. It's another one of those songs like Rivers of Babylon. It's so sad, but it makes you feel uplifted It's a very strange thing. Some of these songs have such quality. They're sad, but their uplifting spirit is so intrinsic in it, so beautiful. Oh. I'm sorry, Tua, did I interrupt you? I think I interrupted you.
It's all good.
It's all good.
So, I think that's... Hannah needs to go to bed. It's late in England. And... we have something else.
I always have something to say to you, you know. It's always thank you. It's always reminder to stay calm. Don't forget to breathe. Come, you know, it's so easy to find a mantra these days. Once you had to go to India, now you can Google a mantra, you know. So hey, look for something that helps you just to stop your mind for a while. Because like I said the other day, you can be locked in the room, but your mind is all over the world, you know. So we really need to find ways. That's all meditation is. It's just finding a way to befriend our inner world so that the mind is not so important for a while. It still goes, but it does its thing. It's not part of our reality. You know, it's a bit like the symbol of the cross, I think, because of Easter. It's the mind is like this, you know, it just goes from on and on this way. And the spirit is this way. That's the symbol of the cross, you know, where it meets in the heart. That's the key. It's the heart center. Because when we're in the heart center, we can choose to live in the basement, as Osho talks about it, or in the sestra. Is that the right word?
Sahastra.
Isn't it? Sahastra, yeah. You know. So that's what we're doing. We're channeling energy, all of us. And because we're connected on a global level, we are supporting each other. Rather than just doing it alone in our rooms, we know that everybody who's connected is in the same spirit as us, and the same intention, and with the same sincerity, but not the same seriousness. No more seriousness. That's the virus. What do you say? Let's just stay sincere. Look out for your friends. Stay connected through the internet. Be creative.
Loka samasta.
Loka samasta. Sukhino. Bhavantu loka samasta sukhino bhavantu loka samasta sukhino.
Maybe we should take our phones out and take photos of ourselves in our temples, and we could share each other's temples all over the world. That would be beautiful too. Anyway, namaste.
Namaste. Namaste. Namaste.